Welcome back to Live on Bowen, now with ratings. Last week, Hayman and I checked out the 007 exhibition, which is currently on in Melbourne. Let's take a look. It's been 50 years since Ian Fleming's first ever James Bond film graced our screens. The suave and sophisticated MI6 agent has appeared in six separate incarnations since the film series began, from Sean Connery to Daniel Craig. And to celebrate this, the Melbourne Museum has launched its new exhibition, Designing 007. We're here with Shane, exhibition manager of Designing 007. Now, Shane, this is 50 years since the first Bond movie came out. What has kept him so classy over the years?
I think there's a lot of work to keep him classy. There's the cars, obviously, as we can see here, the lovely suits, and a lot of work done into the design and the look and feel of the films.
What can people expect when they come on down to have a look at the exhibition here for Designing 007?
Well, we've got objects from every film, lots of fashion, Bond girls' dresses, gadgets, of course.
And what would you rate as the most prized or expensive items at the exhibition here?
Pretty hard to go past the Aston Martin DB5, still a working car from GoldenEye and Skyfall.
And it still runs.
Yep, still goes.
Amazing. That'd be worth a pretty penny.
Probably, yes, yeah.
Or a money penny. Moving on.
Tell me, what does it take to be a Bond girl?
Well, I think you need a lot of style, a lot of mystery, need to be willing to fall in love with James Bond very quickly.
Yeah, I could do that. Anything that I could do to help me become a Bond girl? Any special training or any particular brand of underwear that I could wear?
There's probably a whole list of that kind of thing.
Yeah?
But I think the most important thing is you really need a good name.
The cars, the items, are they all sourced original from the movies or recreated for the exhibition?
Nearly everything you'll see is from the original films. There's a couple of costumes, the really iconic early costumes they've decided to recreate. The exhibition was put together by the production company who make the films, so they're in the last few decades, kept everything from the movies, started up their own archive, so it's all stuff from their archive.
Because I want to be the first Australian Bond girl, these are my names. Victoria Bitter, watch out, Bond, or I'm Bindi Galore, you're going down. Don't know why, if I want to be Australian, she's got an English accent.
Who do you think could be playing Bond in the upcoming future?
Don't know, I've heard a few rumours. I know Daniel Craig's booked on for the next one more I think, and then we'll hand over to someone else. Not sure, they might be looking for someone in Australia.
Personally, I'd like to see Hugh Jackman out there.
Oh yeah, yeah.
But besides myself, yeah, obviously I'll put forward Hugh Jackman.
G'day, I'm Shazza Malone. I'll shake your martini.
Or I was thinking LMNOP, which has got a bit of learning in there for the kids as well.
Hayman, there was already an Australian Bond girl, Chrysantha Harris.
Yeah. And now to a man who hires a troll to guard his pot of gold. It's Michael Connell!
Thank you, Aaron! I don't have a credit card, because I'm too impulsive, right? Whenever I see something that I can buy, just instantly, I want it. You know, like, new car, yes. Bowl of sugar, I want that. Magic beans, what a deal! Getting this, right? And that would be the worst way to go broke as well, just buying random junk. You know, I'm worried that that's what's going to happen to me if I got a credit card. I'd end up broke from buying all this random junk. I'd end up living under a bridge. Some other homeless guy there going, oh, I blew 90 grand on strippers and coke. And I'd be like, oh, iTunes downloads. Bought a lot of stuff off infomercials. You know, like, he's got a great story. I've just got a George Foreman grill. It's not cool, right? And so what I do to stop myself going crazy, I just pay for everything in cash. And I thought when I started doing that, I'd be paying for stuff in cash and people would be going, ooh, fiscally responsible. But what actually happens is I pay for stuff in cash and people are like, ooh, drug dealer. It's not a good look. With a credit card, you can pay with a tap now. Have you seen that? You can tap and you can pay for stuff with a credit card. They say that's to save time. Save time. Really? Who wanted that? Who was buying stuff with a credit card before, like, oh, that's taking too long. No, I'm not buying this insulin. The reason, it's not a time-saving device. The reason they have the tap is the less you think about what you're buying, the more likely you'll buy it, right? That's why they had the swipe, now they got the tap. Soon it'll just be a chip in your brain. You know, you'll be watching TV, there'll be an ad for McDonald's, you're like, oh yeah, I should buy it. Oh, I already have. How convenient, right? And people go, that's what people like. People like the convenience of the credit cards. People go, oh, it's good, Michael. You know, credit cards, if you can't afford something but you want something, using credit cards are great. You know, the credit card gets the stuff for you, and then you have to pay them back. And I'm like, yeah, but that's the same deal with the mafia. You know, they're like, yeah, I get this thing for you. Later on, you gotta pay me back. If you don't, I'll break your legs. People are like, yeah, still better than MasterCard. It's not that bad. And the other thing, when I tell people I don't have a credit card, people freak out. They're always like, oh, but what do you do when you're out late at night? That you can't, if you don't have a credit card, you can't use an ATM. And I'm like, yeah, because that's when I'm making good financial choices. Drunk at 2 a.m. I've never got drunk, been out drinking, be like, yeah, let's open a term deposit. Never happened. That's it from me. Back to you, Aaron.
Please thank Michael Connell. He's more still to come. You're watching live on Bowen.
Tottie Goldsmith, we've got stand-up from Jay Morrissey and a live performance from Fuze. You're watching live on Bowen.